Hey everybody, today we're going to talk about gear blanks, how to calculate their size to make a perfect gear, and the arbors they go on. We'll cover it all. So what we want to do is get a gear blank like this to fit on an arbor like this and end up in the full progression to look like this with your finished gear here. The calculations relate to the diameter of the blank, the number of teeth, and the pitch or module of the gear.
All right, so we come into our homepage here and let's go to our resources where the calculators are. We'll go to the gear blank dimension calculator. And the dimension we're looking for is the outside diameter. That's the one that relates to the number of teeth and these other gear parameters, module and pressure angle. For this one, we're going to have an 18-tooth gear, a module of 2, pressure angle of 14.5, 4 decimals, and we'll calculate. Now, if we come down below, we see that it gives us all our gear parameters here, but let's also look at some of the functionality of this too. Let's copy it, and we'll take it over to Excel for some more analysis. All right, over here in Excel, you just paste it in, and everything comes in just fine in terms of numbers. But here are your key outputs here. These are the diameters. So our outer diameter, this is what you need to give using your drawing to draw the gear blank outside diameter. It's really key to get the everything to work right. Here's your pitch diameter. It's the line at which everything acts, base diameter and a root diameter. Now, these are just some other key working pieces of information for machining, but it repeats all your inputs. It gives you these key outputs. And this outer diameter, that's your outside diameter of your gear blank. And you got to watch your base diameter and your hobbed diameter for your arbor to make sure it's not too large and get in the way. So there's some clearance information here in this data right here. Okay, we're back again, but except this time we're on a mobile device. So here's our gear blank calculator. I've already populated with same exact parameters as we did on desktop. I'm going to hit calculator. Gives us the same information as desktop. Copy that. Send it to somebody in an email or do what you please with it. But works on a mobile device as well.
Now let's look in detail at one more thing. Look at all these arbors. And on this side, you see that these have some kind of gear marks in them, but they're not gears. And so if you see all these marks here, especially on this arbor, those marks, these little marks, these marks, those are unintentional marks from a hobbing machine that are imparted on the work holding. So it's not something you want to do on purpose, because you'd rather have your cutting tool only cutting the gear. All right, so the reason the arbor matters so much is it's got to fit the machine, in this case a straight shank, but it also needs to have a smaller outside diameter so that when you cut the gear, it doesn't cut your arbor. Now, cutting the arbor is really not a big deal, but you're going to pay a lot for your cutting tools. You want them to last a long time. So the root diameter is also in our calculations over there we just showed. And if it's smaller than this diameter, then you're clear. So the guys in the shop that did this accidentally, you earn the title of NutHobber, which is a little bit below apprentice, maybe a little bit above the guy that sweeps the shop. Now, the differences on these arbors over here is these have Morse taper 3 taper on the back, right here, that's a taper. And this is a tapered adapter. I don't know if you can see that in here. So the modern hobbing machine might turn and hob all at once, but the older machines, you need to make the gear blank, usually on a lathe, and then transfer it to your machine. So you want to be as concentric as possible. This is a Morse Taper 3 adapter. This is a Warner and Swayze piece. You can put this in your lathe. It's got a Morse Taper arbor in it, and you can mount your gear here, typically with that type of keyway, and use this to cut your gear blank. Use the same setup without the adapter in your adapter for your hobbing machine so that you can have the minimum number of changes. You want to be as concentric as possible. Now these are a part of the tree. So what happens is we design lots of gear blanks in a row and we cut them all on the lathe as one long piece. And so this is the leftover piece that was in our adapter, and we hobbed all the way down here and nipped that last piece. Sacrificial arbor really is what that ends up being. It's a little bit wasteful of material, but sometimes when you're making low counts, it's the way to go. All right, let's come over here and look at these machines that we're going to work with. All right, so we're trying to make this blank of the specific OD. Just simply, we'll make it in the lathe of the right outside diameter, but we need to put a hole in it as well. So there's OD and ID work and face work. So this we can make one more gear blank, but this is kind of the progression. Raw material to this blank, and then cut it to this face width, and then cut the teeth in it. In particular, this one's the straight arbor, and this can go straight in the lathe and hold it. We can cut it this way. You really need to have some sort of keyway in your gear, a way to hold it on there very tightly so it won't spin. But that'll allow you to cut your OD and ID on this gear. Typically, cut it without that, just straight in the lathe with the stock. Sometimes collets for very small pieces. So that's an example of a straight arbor in the lathe. And here's another one. This one's, we talked about earlier, it's an adapter, so it's a Morse Taper 3 inside of a straight tapered piece here, so it'll fit in your lathe. And this allows you to do some work on the OD of your lathe here, get it all concentric, so that the point is we want to take this Morse Taper 3 out of here and take it over to our hobber and make sure it stays as concentric as possible. We prefer to not have as many setups as this, but this is the nature of the business. All right, this is a small gear hobber. It's made by Pfauter. They've been around for a very long time, and the mechanism here is very standard. Even the new ones today are built with this type of gear train. Here's your hobbing bit, your cutter. That's what makes the gear teeth. And in this particular case, we have an adapter here that we showed just a minute ago, and it fits right in the machine. And it holds the Morse Taper. It'll hold a Morse Taper 3 arbor. Nice precision fit. And you know, we bring this from the Lathe arbor adapter. We put it right in here. And we normally have a gear blank on here, and this is where the hobbing happens, right here. There's a hob nut to go with it. Yeah, the vertical videos are great for Instagram. But this little bug...